Hello, I'm Miss Trish. I'm one of the RE teachers for UU St. Petersburg, and I'm here with the lesson for the 4th of October. So I'm going to light the chalice. Love is the spirit of this church and service its law. This is our great covenant. To dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another. This week's lesson is called Listen to Your Heart. Our faith asks us to practice compassion. It's part of our second UU principle, which goes justice, equality, and compassion in human relations. So, what's one way that our faith guides us into becoming a people of deep listening? It tells us to listen to your heart's call and to be compassionate. I have something here that can help us to think about deep listening. It says one ear. I'm going to try it on. Fits. What? You said that's not an ear? Well, I can hear with it. Still not an ear? Well, the box said one ear, and the lesson said one ear. So, what do you think? Well, when you listen with your heart, you can find out how people feel. Part of deep listening is listening with our heart to hear another person and to truly feel what they're feeling. It's one way to show compassion. I think it means really paying attention when someone is trying to tell you something. Bossy said that she had something to say. What, Bossy? Isn't Bossy cute? You're not listening. Bossy's over here just chattering away. Love Bossy. You have to really listen. Are you talking to me, Bossy? Isn't Bossy cute? You have to pay attention and listen with your heart. Are you trying to tell me something, Bossy? Pay attention and listen with your heart. Why always do that, Bossy? Yeah. So I have a story about deep listening. Thank you, Bossy. You want to be part of the story? Not this time. Okay, you can sit over here and listen. There's Bossy. Well, I hope this story will help you to listen with your heart a little better. And we'll do a little bit of thick listening. So, for this story, it's a story called, what is it? Thick Listening. From stories by Christine C. Robinson and Alice Hawkins. And it's from Thick Listening Stories, Thick Stories. And there are two people that tell the story, and one is Christine. So here's Christine telling the story. A few years after Hurricane Katrina, a friend and I were taking a cab to the New Orleans airport, and the driver, a native New Orleanian, began to talk about how badly people had behaved during the storm, telling stories from hyped-up news programs he'd watched, all of which we had also heard, some of which had proved to be false. To get him off that distressing subject, I asked him about his own experience during the storm. He quickly warmed to the task and started telling his story. Now I'm the cab driver. Well, yeah, I lost everything I had. It was terrible. But I was lucky. I had really good homeowners insurance, and they helped me to get set up again and helped me to relocate. And I was also really lucky that I worked for a good company that helped me out a lot. I worked for Walmart. I was one of their managers. And when I was relocated to Baton Rouge, I got in touch with the home office right away, and they gave me a task to do. They asked me to hunt down every employee that I could find from my store and give them a check for $2,000. Can you imagine? $2,000? And I had all these checks. So I drove all over the place and I found all the employees that I could find and gave them each a check. They were so grateful, and it was really thrilling for me to hand out that money and help those people out. And it really helped me too to have something to do and to help others. And the money helped me. So I guess it wasn't all so terrible. So Christine continues the story that cab driver remembered with pleasure his experience of being trusted in such an extraordinary way and of being able to generously help out his coworkers. Our ride to the airport went all too quickly as we listened, fascinated and moved by his wonderful story. That one cab ride that ended a lot better than it started had really changed the way that I remembered that time period. All I had done, really, was redirect the cabbie away from the oft-repeated gossip about events neither one of us had experienced, and towards his own experiences of those profound weeks. As often happens when people tell their personal stories, I didn't have to prod him or interpret. I hardly said a word between my questions and my thank yous as we paid him at the airport, and this wonderful story kept pouring out, thick as molasses. Whenever the subject of Hurricane Katrina comes up, I remember it still. So, what do you think that was the lesson of that story? If there's somebody there with you, you can pause the video, retell the story, and exchange your ideas of what you think the lesson of that story was. And later, you can ask someone who has done some deep listening how their deep listening affected how they felt and how they behaved and how the teller of the story they were listening to felt and behaved. How that deep listening actually changed things. So now I'm going to turn it over to Miss Janae for the next part of the presentation. I love you all, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.